My name is Geir Skeier. I'm a chef from Norway. I won the Bocuse d'Or in 2009, which is the world championship for cooking. Today I'm in Singapore to prepare some Norwegian seafood, and it's a great pleasure to be here in Singapore and doing this promotion for Norwegian seafood.
The king crab is this one. You see, it's a quite big crab. It can be maybe 2 meters from one leg to the other, so it's very big. These ones are around 4 to 5 kilo when they're whole. So the head is like this size. So it's a very big crab. It's the Norwegian prawns, which are very sweet. It's the one that the Japanese call amaeri. So it's sweet prawns. And we made a soup out of that, and we also have some boiled prawns in the soup, and we have pan-fried some king crab that we put in the soup. So everything should, when you eat it, you should get the real flavor of Norwegian shellfish. It has a lot of sweetness and a lot of good flavors. So we also have some fennel in this dish and a little bit of orange. So, because I think that enhances the flavors of these prawn and king crab. These scallops, alive, airborne from Norway, they are hand-picked by divers. So the diver go down and catch this and put it in boxes and fly it to Singapore. So this was probably in the sea maybe 3-4 days ago. So it's still alive. They keep this on, so it's closed, so it will keep alive for at least 14 days if it's kept cold. I also pick them myself because I also do diving, so it's very nice to go out in the cold water and catch some scallops for dinner. Scallops is also very sweet because of the cold, clear waters in Norway. All the seafood gets a lot of sweetness, because it's used a lot of time to get big. And when they are at this size, they are between 5 and 7 years old. So it takes a long time. You can actually count here, you can see the white stripes. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and a half years old. We actually served this when I were in Singapore 3 years ago. I worked for a seafood company here. And we had, the World Gourmet Summit, and it was a Japanese chef here, very famous Japanese chef. And he had big problems because he didn't get his scallops from Japan, the Hokkaido scallops. So he said, oh, but we have the live Norwegians. No, I don't want it. And we said, yeah, please, we guarantee you'll be happy, but please just try it. And he tried it, and he said, after this, the Norwegian scallops are the best. So he wanted to get this into Japan. So that says a lot about the quality, because Japanese, of course, they are very proud of their own products. And we are, of course, but so hopefully this will be a good dish for you. We will serve it in the shell, so you have to open it as you do when you catch it yourself. But we have prepared it, so it's pan-fried. When you pan fry the shellfish, it gets caramelized. It gives a lot more taste into the shellfish. Pan fried and served with some green peas and some edamame, soya beans. So that's the Japanese influence. And on top, it's a sauce made of champagne and the skirt. Around the scallops, it gives a lot of good flavor as well. This is a 4 to 5 kilo whole salmon with head and everything. As Christian said, it's fresh. You can get it in 48 hours from Norway. So this is the thing that Norway are most known for of seafood. It's farmed, but it's very sustainable the way they farm the salmon in Norway. So it's high quality and always the same quality. The salmon loy is baked in the oven on a low temperature, around 40 to 45 degrees. It's wrapped in nori leaves, which is the Japanese nori leaves. But we also have a tradition in Norway of using a lot of seaweed in our food. So the nori is a good way of enhancing the seafood flavor and the umami of the dish. It's also underneath the nori, we put a little bit of miso paste and mustard. That's also to enhance the seafood flavor. It's served on top of asparagus, because this is a very summery dish. So it's not the right season for Norway to serve this now, but in Singapore it's always summer. So then we do this. And on the side you have the skin of the salmon with a little bit of meat, which has been cured for one day with aquavit. So it's like gravet salmon, which is very traditional in Norway and Sweden. We also fried it a little bit on the skin side. So the skin is fried, but underneath it's raw salmon. And on top it's pickled vegetables. It's very traditional Norwegian to have pickled vegetables with salmon. So it's cucumber, some onion, and red radish, and also some salmon raw on top.
My personal favorite dish of the dishes today is maybe the cod, because I really like the cod at this time of year. It's winter in Norway, and then the cod is really good because then the water are even colder, and the flesh of the cod gets really tender and very, very nice. I think Singaporeans can appreciate the pureness in the Norwegian cooking, because you can always taste you can see what you taste. So when you get the cod, you will taste cod and you will feel the texture of the cod and all of this. And we are also very important for us to have acidity in the dishes, so it's balanced with acidity and fat. So I think it's a kind of worldwide taste buds can appreciate Nordic cooking. The most important thing or the hardest thing when you do food like we do is that everything has to be perfect, because it's not so many ingredients and it's quite simple. It's not done too much with everything, so all the things you put on the plate has to be perfect. The perfect temperature of the fish, the perfect cooking of the vegetables, the perfect taste of the sauce and the temperature of the sauce. So it's small things that's the most important when you make this kind of food.